Amidst the ongoing debate on the increasing price hike on petrol and diesel, the Union Minister KJ Alphons justified this hike by stating that the government is going to tax those people who can afford to pay. He also stated that this money would be used for the welfare of the poor.
So we are going to tax people who can afford to pay. Who buys petrol? Somebody who's got a car? Somebody who's got a bike? Certainly he's not starving. So somebody who can afford to pay has to pay. Yes, we are imposing the taxes so that the poor of this country will have a dignified life.
That was KJ Alphons there effectively saying that if you can afford to buy a two-wheeler or a four-wheeler, then you should be able to afford the price hike on petrol and diesel. You should be able to afford the taxes levied on petrol and diesel. Now, after that controversial statement, Times Network confronted KJ Alphons, but he's now gone silent on the issue altogether. Take a look.
Alphons, sir.
Hey, how are you?
Very well,
KTM
president.
Thank you very much.
Alphons, sir. So you made a comment that those people are using cars and bikes, are not starving.
No, I'm not speaking. I'm not speaking.
Yeah. What is your reaction on that? Absolutely true. I confronted him twice in this Mascot Paradise where he was supposed to attend a meeting with the tourism officials from Kerala. I asked him his comments on this. So, sir, if you can just explain what you actually meant. But he said, no, I'm not interested to talk on this issue. He clearly said the same thing twice. And then I also spoke to the BJP leaders here, the state BJP leaders. Even they said that, they don't want to comment on this. They say that there's some section of media has actually, has actually tried to make some controversy, and they actually wanted to create some controversy, and that's what they want to do here. But it's very evident from the press meet which he has conducted from the BJP headquarters that he clearly said that those people who are paying, who are buying petrol and diesel, who have cars and who use bikes and car, are not starving, and then they should pay the taxes. This is actually, it looks like, this comment has actually backfired him. People from various sections of the political segment, CPM, Congress, have actually criticized him in a strong language on this particular issue.
That's correct. And a bizarre justification coming in from KJ Alphons, the Union Tourism Minister, on the steep fuel price hike in India. He says that people who can afford to pay are being taxed. People who have cars, who have bikes, and who don't have a problem with this taxation system are being taxed, and there is nothing wrong with the steep fuel price hike. He also goes on to say that this will in fact benefit the poor, and that money will be taken care of for the welfare of the poor. Remember, this is not the first time KJ Alphons has made a controversial statement. Earlier, he had also made another statement on beef, and with this statement, of course, a lot of people are not happy with this kind of justification. They say that they're not happy with the kind of steep price hike that India has seen for fuel, and with this statement they say that this is absolutely unnecessary. Amita Balachandra for Mirror Now.
अब उसमें क्या कहना, जो सरकार बनी है ना, अब सरकार को ऐसे पेट्रोल बढ़ रहा है, बढ़ने तो और कितना मजा आता देखेंगे ना।
अच्छे दिन की बात बोली थी,
अच्छे दिन का बात तो हमेशा बोल रहे हैं, आए क्या अच्छे दिन अभी तक? आप बोलो ना, आप कार्यकर्ता हो, आप बोलो अच्छे दिन आए नहीं आए ना? जैसा सबको मंजूर है वैसा हमको मंजूर है, चल रहा है, चलने दो।
ये अच्छे दिन तो सरकार के अच्छे दिन है, हम लोग के कोई अच्छे दिन नहीं आए। पेट्रोल का भाव बढ़ गया है, हर चीज का भाव बढ़ गया है, सामान्य जनता अफोर्ड नहीं कर सकती ये सब चीज। बर्थडे के दिन मोदी जी ने बहुत बढ़िया गिफ्ट दिया जनता को कि जनता रो रही है और बड़े बड़े नेता बीजेपी के वो सब खुश है एकदम, उनके लिए बहुत से अच्छे दिन है, आम जनता के लिए अच्छे दिन नहीं है।
ये जो पेट्रोल और डीजल का दाम बढ़ रहा है, और अभी मिनिस्टर ने बोला है कि ये जो पैसा कलेक्ट किया जाता है वो गरीब के लिए जाता है, आपका क्या कहना है?
60-80 रुपए जो उसको पेट्रोल लगाने हैं, पूरा दिन में 300 रुपए कमाता है उसमें, जो एक लीटर में 80 रुपए का पेट्रोल जाता है उसका, तो क्या करेगा आदमी?
देखा जाए तो अमीर आदमी अमीर ही बनता जा रहा है और गरीब आदमी गरीब ही बनता जा रहा है। अभी ये देखो, जो भी गवर्नमेंट ने किया है कि हाँ 80 रुपए क्या है, 78 रुपए क्या है, तो गरीब कैसे ले सकता है? नहीं ले सकता है। और बोल रहे हैं कि अमीर लोग क्या बोलेंगे, हाँ चलो 10 रुपए बढ़ाया फिर भी चलेगा, लेकिन गरीब को 1 रुपए के लिए मेहनत करना पड़ता है।
तो सरकार क्या करता है, बढ़ा देता है 2-4 रुपए से बढ़ाता है, जब कम करता है तो 1 ही रुपया 80 पैसा ऐसे कम करते हैं, बोलता है कि सरकार कम कर रहा है, कम कर, कहाँ कम कर रहा है।
तो क्या आपको लगता है जो मिनिस्टर ने कहा है तो वो बिल्कुल गलत है?
हाँ वो तो सही है, क्योंकि उनका पूरा मानना ही गलत है, क्योंकि 1 रुपया बढ़ा दिया है फिर भी उनको कितना फायदा भी मिलता है गवर्नमेंट को, लेकिन वो यूज कहाँ कर रहे वो नहीं दिखा रहे। उन्होंने दिखाना चाहिए कि हाँ वो बोल रहे हैं ना गरीब के लिए हम दे रहे हैं, तो उन्होंने दिखाना चाहिए हाँ इतना इतना दिया है हमने, इतना गरीब के खाते में दिया है, गरीब को बांट रहे हैं, वो दिखाना चाहिए बस।
Absolutely. So there you go. Commuters are saying that where is the accountability, if at all it is going to the poor, where is the accountability of whether it is actually going to the poor and it's being used for developmental activities in the country. That's something that is a big question mark. In fact, these people say that the statement itself is extremely bizarre and unnecessary. Amita Balachandra, Kumira.
Well, the citizens at large are not very happy with the statements, or at the same time, you know, they're not happy with the fuel rise as well. We're going to right now, you know, talk to one of these customers who are at the petrol pump right now, and we're going to ask him the same thing. Sir, pichle 3 mahine mein itna zyada petrol price badh chuka hai, uspe kya kahenge?
Pehle 500 ka tha, ab 300 ka dalwa rahe hain. Yehi hai bas.
सर एक यूनियन गवर्नमेंट में एक मिनिस्टर हैं, उन्होंने कहा है कि अगर आपके पास गाड़ी है, आपके पास बाइक है, तो ऑब्वियसली आप भूखे नहीं मर रहे हैं, तो उस पर आप क्या कहेंगे कि पेट्रोल का प्राइस आपको देना पड़ेगा, ऐसा उनका बयान आया है?
उनको तो सरकारी मिल रहा है ना पैसा, हमारी अपनी जेब से आ रहा है, उनको तो गवर्नमेंट दे रही है, उनका बिजली का बिल, टेलीफोन का बिल, जो भी है उनको नहीं पता, इन चीज़ों से मतलब नहीं है उनका।
ये बड़ी प्रॉब्लम हो रखा है, हम लोगों के जो लिमिटेड इनकम है, इनकम में उससे डेली पेट्रोल डालते डालते हम परेशान हो रखा है, अब क्या करेंगे उसके, गवर्नमेंट इसके लिए कुछ करना ही जरूरी है।
He wants us to starve, that's how, that's what he wants.
That seems to be the statement, he's saying that, you know, if you have a car, clearly you're not starving. Those are the words of the minister.
Fine, we are not starving, but that doesn't mean it's a leisure thing, that we need a car, it's a time of need. Like this, a car is something that is needed now. For our day-to-day activities. Exactly. The public transport is not such and not so frequent that we rely on the public transport. So,
at the same time, ma'am, would you also, you know, confirm, would you also say that, you know, fuel price not only affects a household, but at a time like this, it also affects the inflation level?
Of course it does. At all the levels, it does affect the inflation level at all levels. Because not only each household, but every other commodity affects because of the petrol prices.
Now, predictably, that statement has sparked a political war of words. Let's listen into some of the reactions that are coming in.
3 saal pehle kya vaade kiye the Hindustan ke logon se? Un vaadon ka kya hua? Aaj desh ki salat par hai, desh ki arthvyavastha charmara gayi hai, naukriyan toot gayi hain. $50 par ek barrel aap import karke laate hain, ayat karke tel ko, jo pehle 109 aur 114 डॉलर में मिलता था, तब तो कीमत दिल्ली में पेट्रोल की 1 लीटर की 71 रुपए थी और 63 रुपए में डीजल मिलता था, तो आज क्यों लोगों से आप मुनाफा ले रहे हैं, उपभोक्ता को परेशान कर रहे हैं, ये तमाम बातें हैं देश के सामने।
बट व्हाट अबाउट द पीपल हु विल ट्रैवल बाय डीटीसी द बस सर्विस ऑफ द स्टेट हु विल गो बाय third class in trains, will the minister give a guarantee that they will not raise the fare because petrol or diesel has gone up in value? So it's not only the direct users of petrol who are affected, but the indirect users who are common people, and especially farmers who use diesel for pumps, for pumping irrigation water, they all be affected. In my opinion, this fare hike is totally uncalled for, because it's not a question of balancing the costs. It's a question of it, for a large country like ours, we should make the travel very cheap. And our petrol and diesel rates are much too high. and they have no relationship with the cost of 1 liter of petrol after taxes, insurance, everything. If you add everything at the petrol pump when it is delivered for sale, including the petrol pump commission, is 35 rupees per liter. Why should you charge 80 rupees?